A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. One of the multitudes said to him, "Teacher, bid my brother divide the inheritance with me." But he said to him, "Men, who make me a judge or divider over you?" And he said to them, "Take heed and beware of all covetousness, for a man's life does not consist in the abundance of his possessions." And he told them a parable, saying, "The land of a rich man brought forth plentifully, and he thought to himself, 'What shall I do, for I have nowhere to store my crops?' And he said, 'I will do this. I will pull down my barns and build larger ones, and there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, Soul, you have ample goods laid up for many years. Take your ease, eat, drink, be merry.' But God said to him, 'Fool, this night your soul is required of you, and the thing you have prepared, whose will they be? So is he who lays up treasure for himself and is not rich toward God?" The word of the Lord. Meditation. Have you ever tried to settle a money dispute or an inheritance issue? Inheritance disputes are rarely ever easy to resolve, especially when the relatives or close associates of the deceased benefactor cannot agree on who should get what and who should get the most. Why did Jesus refuse to settle an inheritance dispute between two brothers? He saw that the heart of the issue was not justice or fairness, but rather greed and possessiveness. Loving possessions rather than loving my neighbor. The Ten Commandments were summarized into two prohibitions: do not worship false idols and do not covet what belongs to another. It's the flip side of the two great commandments: love God and love your neighbor. Jesus warned the man who wanted half of his brother's inheritance to beware of all covetousness. To covet is to wish to get wrongfully what another possesses, or to begrudge what God has given to another. Jesus restates the commandment, "Do not covet," but he also states that a person's life does not consist in the abundance of his or her possessions. The fool who were possessed by his riches. Jesus reinforces his point with a parable about a foolish rich man. Why does Jesus call this wealthy landowner a fool? Jesus does not fault the rich man for his industriousness and skill in acquiring wealth, but rather for his egoism and selfishness. "It's mine, all mine, and no one else." This parable is similar to the parable of the rich man who refused to give any help to the beggar Lazarus. The rich fool had lost the capacity to be concerned for others. His life was consumed with his possessions, and his only interest was in himself. His death was the final loss of his soul. What is Jesus' lesson on using material possessions? It is in giving that we receive. Those who are rich toward God receive ample reward, not only in this life, but in eternity as well. Where is your treasure? In this little parable, Jesus probes our hearts. Where is your treasure? Treasures had a special connection to the heart, the place of desire and longing, the place of will and focus. The thing we most set our heart on is our highest treasure. What do you treasure above all else? Let us pray. Lord Jesus, free my heart from all possessiveness and from coveting what belongs to another. May I desire you alone as the one true treasure worth possessing above all else. Help me to make good use of the material blessings you give me, that I may use them generously for your glory and for the good of others. Amen.